If you're performing Make Ready Engineering in Catapult Pro, you're in luck. Our program comes with default Make Ready clearance rules that are programmed into the software to automatically calculate violations during the Make Ready process. When you're setting up your model, you'll have the option to base your Make Ready rules on the NESC or GO95. From there, you can add further rules based on your market's needs, and that's what we'll be exploring today. In the model editor, we'll be navigating to the clearance rules section nested under the Make Ready section. We'll see a searchable list of wires and equipment that have rule sets set up in the software. If we right-click on any of these items, we'll have the option to rename them, copy them, or delete them. We'll click on one of these rule sets to open the clearance rules details view. There are three columns: the rule requirements, pole clearances, and midspan clearances, which can be toggled on or off. In the rule requirements, this is where we make specifications as to what this should apply to. The marker type is where you essentially select which annotation type this rule applies to. For example, in this rule set for fiber, the marker type is wire. The next couple of sections are required marker attributes and required trace attributes. Remember, marker attributes are any attributes that exist on a particular marker. Diameter would be an example. This is an attribute that affects the one specific marker in the job. Trace attributes are attributes that exist and are linked throughout a cable's entire trace. Examples of this would include cable type and company. So these sections are for specifying what kind of marker attributes and trace attributes must exist on the marker in order to qualify for this clearance rule. For example, for this fiber clearance rule, we don't have any necessary marker attributes, but we have a required trace attribute where cable type must be fiber optic comm because we want this rule to apply to all fiber optic comm cables. Or if we look at this removed wire example, it doesn't have any required trace attributes, but it has a required marker attribute where MR remove is checked because this rule applies to a specific wire that has been removed. This little blue bubble in the corner can be toggled between all or any. If all is selected, then all of the attributes are required. If any is selected, it means at least one of the attributes is required. For example, in this proposed fiber clearance rule, under the required trace attributes, there are two attributes required. Cable type has to be fiber optic comm and proposed has to be checked. The all in the corner means both of these attributes and their values must be met. The last part of the rule requirements column is this rule exceptions section. Here, you can include any information for exceptions to the rule. When an exception to the rule is flagged, the exception explanation provided here will show up when you click on that marker's info button, the little white eye icon on the left-handed marker. For example, in this streetlight drip loop, there is an exception that says clearance can be changed to 3 inches if drip loop is guarded. Next is the pole clearances column. In the pole clearances is a table of clearance rules. Under distance is the distance in inches, the direction can be set to below, above, or from, and the clearance rule is what the rule should be applied to in the software. So in this fiber example, the first row here has a distance of 4, direction of from, and clearance rule of streetlight grounded. We can see that for the streetlight grounded clearance rule, this is applied whenever the marker type is equipment, the equipment type is set to streetlight, and the grounded attribute is checked. Therefore, this first rule is saying that a fiber optic comm must be 4 inches from a grounded streetlight. There is a checkbox under Ignore Existing Violations. When this is checked, existing violations of the rule will be ignored. If there are any make-ready calls that are made that violate this rule, only those will be flagged. At the bottom of this list is an option to add a clearance rule. Again, the first input is the distance, which you can enter or use these arrows. Next is a drop-down for the direction. Then there's a drop-down for the clearance rule to select. And then there's a checkbox for whether existing violations should be ignored or not. The last item you'll see in a row is a trash can icon. This will immediately delete the clearance rule when clicked. Finally, we have the midspan clearances. This table functions exactly the way the pole clearances column works, only these clearance rules are applied in the midspan instead of the pole. In some cases, you won't need midspan clearances, such as the case with equipment. Let's walk through an example. We'll create a new clearance rule for a grounded neutral. Instead of starting from scratch, I'm going to copy the neutral clearance rules and tweak them. I'll find my neutral clearance rule, right-click it, select copy, and up here I'm going to add grounded to the clearance rule's name. I'm going to keep the marker type as wire. We're also going to keep the required trace attribute of cable type as neutral. In the required marker attributes, we'll also add grounded and check the checkbox to indicate that this applies to a grounded neutral. Some of our midspan clearances will change. In relation to the driveway clearance rule, the grounded neutral will go from 222 inches to 186 inches. I will also make adjustments for the sidewalk, yard, brush, railroad, and water clearances. And then we'll save our new clearance rule. The order of the clearance rules matters. For instance, a more specific kind of wire or equipment should be placed above a less specific wire or equipment of the same type. So we'll use this Edit Clearance Rule Order button in the top right corner here to move this grounded neutral above the neutral rule. We want the grounded neutral to be checked first because it's a more specific rule than the neutral rule. Finally, I'll click this Save Clearance Rule Order. Congratulations! You've made it through our tutorial for creating make-ready clearance rules. Now you're equipped to manage and adjust these rules according to your market's needs. If you have any questions, you can reach out to our support team. Don't forget to leave a comment to help us improve our documentation or comment any questions you have down below. Let us know what videos you'd like to see next. Thanks for watching!